and there will be pain. There's no pain in this budget. None.
People aren't stupid. You don't fill a $60 million hole and not lay off a single person. People get that that's ridiculous.
Well, 8 months later, a look at the consequences of the city's worst budget crisis. You know, despite a $33 million shortfall, a majority on Cincinnati City Council say that layoffs are not the answer. NewsHour's John London joining us with a look at what that means for safety and other services. John?
Well, Cherie, right now it means no one at City Hall is quite sure how this budget will be balanced. And for all the bluster about getting an early start this time, it looks like it'll go down to the wire at holiday time once again.
It has become almost as familiar a pattern as a city garbage collection route. Dump whatever messy midsummer budget there is right into December's last-minute pile of decision-making.
If we look at making budget cuts right now, and we have a new council in November, it's for naught.
So City Hall is without a budget plan that has sufficient support at the moment. In her first term, Amy Murray is trying to get state approval to alter the city's fiscal year so that council can be decisive in spring instead of under the gun. City managers recommended 44 police layoffs. Factor in annual retirements. His thinking is those 44 could be rehired within a year. His office says a $3.7 million federal grant to retain 50 officers next year is in jeopardy.
And if we don't do the layoffs now, in order to achieve the same $4 million of savings, we'd have to lay off more officers.
West Side activist Pete Whitty sees no need for police cuts, not if money's spent right. He sees too little emphasis on neighborhood economic development in favor of downtown.
But we need to be creating the small mom-and-pop businesses all throughout the city in our neighborhood business districts, and that's what's left behind.
In the wake of police-involved shootings this summer, the mood has shifted away from cutting police to cutting elsewhere.
All right, now Vice Mayor Qualls wants to have an alternative plan from the majority for council to consider by September 7th. Otherwise, it appears the new council elected in November will be deciding in December how to close that $33 million gap. Cherie?